धर्मो केमिकल इक्वेशन है, धर्मो केमिकल इक्वेशन, इट इज द केमिकल इक्वेशन रिप्रेजेंटिंग हीट चेंजेस एंड इट इज द केमिकल इक्वेशन रिप्रेजेंटिंग हीट चेंजेस. सो जनरली वी हैव नंबर ऑफ केमिकल इक्वेशन, जनरली वी हैव नंबर ऑफ केमिकल इक्वेशन. लेट अस टेक नाइट्रोजन रिएक्ट विथ hydrogen to form NH3N. So this is the general chemical equation. So it is the general chemical equation. Okay. So here nitrogen reacts with hydrogen to form ammonia. So nitrogen gas reacts with hydrogen gas to form ammonia gas. Ammonia gas. Okay. So here, so it is unbalanced one. It is an ordinary reaction. But so N2 plus 3H2 gives 2NH3 reaction. N2 plus 3H2 gives 2NH3. This is the chemical reaction which is balanced one. This balanced chemical equation is called as a stoichiometric equation. This balanced chemical equation called as a stoichiometric equation. If this balanced chemical equation is also represented so with energy changes, let us say delta H of this reaction is equal to -92 kilojoules. Delta H is equal to -92 kilojoules. That means it is the chemical equation also explaining heat changes during the course of the reaction. Heat changes during the course of the reaction. So what happened? Heat energy, either it is released or absorbed, that is also explained with the help of this delta H value. This type of chemical equation, which also represents heat changes either with delta H or delta E, are called as a thermochemical equation. That is a balanced equation. That is a balanced equation, also represents heat changes. Okay, so there, the physical states of the reactants and products also mentioned. Physical states of reactants and products also mentioned, so which is called as a thermochemical equation. A thermochemical equation. So this thermochemical equation, see here, what happens? So here delta H value is negative. So whenever delta H value is negative means heat energy released in it. Heat energy released in it. So whenever delta H value is negative, that heat energy release rate. If delta H value is positive, that is heat absorbed. Heat absorbed. Okay. So see here. Why? How? I will explain. So N2 plus O2 gives 2NOR. It is gas. It is gas. It is gas. These are the gases. These are the gases. During this process, delta H is equal to plus 180 kilojoules of energy. So here plus means heat absorbed. Here minus means heat released. So heat release processes are called as exothermic reactions. Heat absorbed reactions are called as endothermic reactions. So why is our heat energy released? Why is our heat energy absorbed? So that is according to your first law of thermodynamics. This thermochemistry is the application of first law of thermodynamics. This thermochemistry is the application of first law of thermodynamics. See here. So let us say, so my dear boys, so this thermochemical equations, two types are. One is exothermic equations, another one is endothermic equations. Exothermic equations, delta H is negative. Endothermic equations, their delta H is positive only. Why that one is negative, that one is positive? I will explain. See here. See here. That is, let us say, A, it is a reactant. It is in gaseous state. So during the course of reaction, this A is changed to B. A is changed to B, which is also in gaseous stage. Now, the energy of this A at constant pressure, so So enthalpy, enthalpy, let it be. Let the enthalpy of this A, that is energy acquisition pressure, is 30 kilojoules. Let the enthalpy of B at that particular temperature is 50 kilojoules of energy. That means 30 joules of A converted into 50 joules of B. How that much 20 kilojoules of energy from what? From where that 20 kilojoules? That means here A has 30 kilojoules of energy, B has 50 kilojoules of energy. So that means 30 in the change it to 50. How is this possible? How is this possible? So that means the difference of energy is how much? So difference is always product value minus reactant value. And product value 50, reactant value 30. That gives a positive value. And that gives a positive value, higher value minus lower value. This value is taken as the delta H. Delta H is equal to enthalpy of products minus enthalpy of reactants. Delta H is nothing but enthalpy of products minus enthalpy of reactants. Here enthalpy of products is 50, enthalpy of reactants is 30. That value is a positive value, which is equal to 20 only. So from where this 20 kilojoules of energy is available for this B? Because this A absorbs 20 kilojoules of energy from surroundings and gets converted into B. Converted into B. That means, so A gains 20 kilojoules of energy from surroundings and converts into B means, so A absorbs something energy. And how much energy is absorbed here? 20 kilojoules of energy is absorbed. So that 20 already exists at 30, that is total contains 50, that 50 is converted into 50 joules is applicable for B. That means in this process, heat is absorbed. Heat is absorbed by A. Reactants absorb energy. That's why it is delta H value is a positive value. So absorbed cases, so it is heat absorbed process. So that is why delta H is a positive end. So delta H is always nothing but enthalpy of products minus enthalpy of reactants. Enthalpy of products minus enthalpy of reactants. This is about our delta H value. So delta H is always enthalpy of products minus. Delta symbol is applicable only for products value minus reactants value. If that is delta H, enthalpy of products minus enthalpy of reactants. If it is delta E, internal energy of products minus internal energy of reactants. Products minus reactants. And that represents enthalpy value. There it is, false value. That is the plus 20. So because it is plus, it is absorbed process. For example, there is C which is in gaseous state. There is C which is in gaseous state having energy 40. It converts into D, so which is also in gaseous state having energy 20. 20. What happened here? 40 joules of energy chemical is changed to 20 joules chemical. That means, so delta H for this process is equal to product value minus reactant value, which is equal to minus 20. It is a negative value. That means, so what happened? So 40 changes to 20 means remaining 20 is released during the process. That means the C converts into D by the loss of 20 kilojoules of energy. So to which this 20 kilojoules of energy is reached? To the surroundings. In this process, C changes to D and releases 20 kilojoules of energy to the surroundings. So that is why, so here delta H value is negative, so which is taken as exothermic, this much heat energy is released. Okay, so during releasing process, delta H is negative energy. During absorption process, delta H is positive energy. Delta H is positive. Okay, this is very, very important. So in this case, the reactions are called as exothermic reactions. So those are considered as endothermic reactions. So see here, finally. A plus 20 kilojoules of energy gives B and E. A takes 20 kilojoules of energy, converts into B. Is this exothermic reaction or endothermic reaction? Tell me, boys. Is this exothermic reaction or endothermic reaction? Tell me. Yes, Harshit, correct. Yes, yes, endothermic end. So here, the same reaction also we represented like this. A gives B minus 20 kilojoules of energy. So both these are same end. This one, both these are same, my dear boys. So here reactant side plus, here product side minus only. Product side minus. The reaction is also, I'm representing like this. That gives B, delta H value is positive. Delta H value is positive. That is how much? Plus 20. How much of this value? Plus 20. Okay? So that means, so this one, this one, this one, all these three are identical. Everything, all these reactions are same energy. All these are endothermic reactions. All these are endothermic reactions. Okay, so like this. So A gains 20 kilojoules of energy converts into B means, or A gives B by the loss of 20 kilojoules of energy. By the loss of 20 kilojoules of energy. Next, A gives B delta H value positive. That is how much value it is resolved? That is 20 kilojoules of energy because it is a release process. So that's right. It is positive. Positive. So because it is absorbent, absorbent towards system end, absorbed cases, positive. Away from the system, losing from the system is nothing but, negative end. Here, absorbed energy towards system end, towards system. That's why it is positive cases end, positive cases. So see here, one more example. C converts into D by the loss of 10 kilojoules of energy. C gives D by the loss of, that means C gives D and releases 10 kilojoules of energy to the surrounding cell, to the surroundings. It is released process. So C loses something energy and it to give B. That is, it is exothermic case. So this one is represented as C minus 10 gives D and C losses 10 kilojoules of energy and converts D and. So the same reaction is also represented as C gives D with the delta H is equal to negative, which is equal to minus 10 N, which is equal to minus 10 N. So this is, all these three reactions are same reactions. All these are exothermic reactions. All these are exothermic reactions. Okay, so these are endothermic reactions, these are exothermic reactions. See, boys, so A converts into B by the gain of something energy, that means B has something more energy in it. B has something more energy. Here, C converts into D by the loss of 10 kilojoules of energy. Here, D is the product which has less energy in it. Which has less energy. So, those products formed in the exothermic reactions or endothermic reaction. If it is endothermic reaction, this product is called as endothermic product. Endothermic product having more energy and having more energy. So during the course of exothermic reaction, a product is formed. This is called as exothermic product. Exothermic product having less energy in it. Because something energy is lost to the surroundings, that's why they convert into product. So here, less is the energy, here is the more is the energy. More is the energy of the chemical, that is why less stable energy. Here, less is the energy, that is why it is taken as more stable energy. More stable energy. That means endothermic products are less stable, exothermic products are more stable because they have less energy. Less energetical products are formed in it. In exothermic reaction, less energetical products are formed. In endothermic reaction, more energetical products are formed. So endothermic products are less energy because they are having more energy in it. So less stable, less stability than that of exothermic products. So these are all exothermic reactions, endothermic reactions. These are nothing but thermochemical equations and thermochemical, that is energy, chemical reactions having energy changes, having energy changes. Okay, in all these cases we represent the heat changes in terms of delta H. Why, sir? Why we are using delta H? Why not we are using delta E? Here delta E terms are generally not used, but delta H terms are used because all these reactions take place in lab. All these reactions are take place in lab. Lab is nothing but a room only. So at this condition, pressure is a constant only. Pressure is a constant. That means all these reactions take place at constant pressure. Heat changes explained at constant pressure. Heat changes in the course of reactions are explained at constant pressure. So that is why we are using only delta H, but not a delta E. But not a delta E. So that is why. So here, so all chemical reactions take place at constant pressure. So here we explain heat changes during constant pressure conditions. So therefore, we are explaining only delta H, that is enthalpy change. Enthalpy change. So it is very, very important. It is very, very important. Next one. Now, what are the factors? What are the factors? Influence factors that influencing delta H. So, what are the factors that influencing delta H? That is heat changes, enthalpy changes. That is enthalpy of the reaction. Enthalpy of the reaction. Enthalpy change of the reaction. What are those factors which influence? That means, so first point, any, there is a physical state of the reactants and products. Reactants and products. So that means if physical change of reactants and products, for example, see here. Here H2O is in solid state. Solid state is changed to H2O liquid. That means physical states are changed. H2O solid changed to H2O liquid. So that means something heat energy is absorbed, led into 20 kilojoules of energy is absorbed. So 20 kilojoules of heat energy is absorbed at solid H2O and converts into H2O liquid. So same H2O solid is now changed to H2O gas and H2O gas. Is the same 20 kilojoules of energy is sufficient to convert that H2O solid into H2O liquid, my dear boys? Is the same 20 kilojoules of energy sufficient or something more or less than? Yes, still required more energy. Still required. So that means maybe 80 kilojoules of energy is required. 80 kilojoules of energy may be required. That means, so if physical state of the materials as reactants or products are changed, automatically enthalpy change also, enthalpy of the change in enthalpy also changes. That means, so enthalpy change, delta H value, depends on the physical states of reactants and products. Physical states of reactants and products. For example, if H2O liquid changes to H2O gas, is 80 kilojoules is required or less than 80 kilojoules is required? Tell me. Is for this conversion, so H2O liquid to H2O gas, no doubt, already liquid state is there, so that liquid is converted into gas, something less than that of 80, let it be 50 kilojoules of energy is sufficient. Any. That means physical state change, automatically change in enthalpy also changes. Automatically, that means, so physical state of the reactants and products influences the change in enthalpy. So that means heat of reaction. Next one. third one, sorry, second one, allotropic forms and allotropic forms of the reactants and products, allotropic forms of the elements. Allotropic forms. See here, what is allotropic? So chemically same, physically different elements. Chemically same, physically different. For example, carbon has graphite, is the allotrope, and also carbon has diamond, is another allotrope. So this graphite reacts with oxygen, gives carbon dioxide gas. This is also here. This diamond also reacts with oxygen, that gives carbon dioxide gas. Both these reactions are same end. Both these reactions are same end. Okay, so see here, graphite and diamond. So here delta H value is plus 20, sorry, minus 20. Here delta H value is minus 18.9 kilojoules of energy end. That means both these are released energies end. But here 20 released, here 18.9 is released end. 18.9 is released. That means, so released energy is one second change because allotropes of elements are changed. So remaining all are constant, all these are same. But here graphite allotrope reacts, here diamond allotrope is reacted. That means, so if allotropes of the elements are changed, automatically change in enthalpy also changed. That means allotropes also influences the heat changes during the course of the reaction. Heat changes to the during the course of the reaction. That means allotropes are the one of the factors that influence the delta H value. Cell. Next one. Third one. Reaction conditions. That is, reaction carried out. Reaction carried out at constant pressure or constant volume. That means situations of the reactants. So different conditions. This is also influences. So next one, quantities. Quantities of reactants involved in the reaction. Quantities of the reactants involved in the reaction. So see here, for example, A reacts with oxygen, gives AO2. So here, A, let it be 10 grams here involved in the reaction. During this course of reaction, delta H is equal to minus 20 kilojoules of energy. Here 10 grams A involved in the reaction. So same A reacts with oxygen, but 30 grams A involved in the reaction, that gives the same AO2, but the heat changes is minus 90 kilojoules of energy. Minus 90 kilojoules of energy. That means if quantity of the reactants or products are changed, quantity of the reactants or products are changed, automatically the change in enthalpy also changes. Automatically, the change in enthalpy also changed. It is very, very important, boys. So, see here, physical state changes, automatically enthalpy changed. Allotropes are, chemicals are involved, automatically enthalpy changed. So, reaction carried out at a constant pressure or at constant value, depending on the situations, automatically the heat changes depending. So, quantities also, that depends. So, the change in enthalpy. So, and last one, and most important one, that is, temperature also influences the change in enthalpy. Temperature also influences on delta H. Temperature also influences the delta H. So these are the factors. So the effect of temperature on delta H is explained by using Kirchhoff's equation. Kirchhoff, that is the scientist name, by. So that Kirchhoff's equation, that Kirchhoff explains the change in delta H value is including along with temperatures and change in delta H value along with temperatures are explained on the basis of Kirchhoff's equation. So this is very, 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 very important. So see here.